Come on along, come on along to the Shiremoor Children's Treat. Come on along, come on along, many old friends you will meet. They come from miles around just to see the children play. It's good to see them happy and enjoy themselves all day. And that's what this is all about. Come on along, come on along, see them marching to the field. Come on along, come on along, if you're tempted, why not yield? If you've never had the pleasure of being here before, here is your chance, it's a never open door. So come and have a look around. Come on along to the Shiremoor Children's Treat. Come on along, many old friends you will meet. So if you wanna see this event keep going and keep the kids happy, come on along to the Shiremoor Children's Treat.
In just a few hours from now, this deserted Northumberland field will be transformed into an event that hundreds of local children will remember for the rest of their lives. Found a member of the committee which first organized this occasion, Mr. Nevin looks out onto an empty school field, and remembers that since the turn of the century, he has been emptying school fields at least once a year, and attracting them to the other empty field we have just seen. The Shiremoor and District Annual Children's Gala will today bring together children and parents to share in these happy tidings, which will last until sunset.
A group of men back in 1907 decided they wanted to put something on. So they got together and went to the council and said, we want to do this. And to raise money for it, they went knocking on the doors around the streets in the Shiremoor area, and got enough money to put the first treat on, and it's carried on every year since.
The Shiremoor and District Children's Treat, founded in 1907, is still with us today, the continued success being largely due to the efforts of committee men like Tommy Green, who for the past 25 years has played a leading part in organising this most popular local event.
I've been on the committee since I was aged 17 years old. The reason I got involved with it originally was because of my dad. He was chairman of the treat committee he was on the treat committee for 40 years from when he was married. He joined the treat committee and I just followed suit. I can't ever remember myself ever missing a treat in all the years I've been going. Even though I spent 6 years in the RAF down London, I still managed to wangle it so I come up and got the weekend off for the treat.
The first arrivals to this deserted Northumberland field are the spearhead of a small army of helpers who during the next few hours will set the scene for an occasion that will be remembered for years ahead by the children and parents who will presently arrive in their hundreds to enjoy this day of fun and enjoyment. Shiremoor and District Children's Annual Gala, first introduced in 1907, because at that time it sounded like a good idea, is perpetuated still today by a committee of 14 members and a host of unpaid helpers who mysteriously arrive year after year, so making the special day the success that it always has been. One of the regular and well-known contributors, both physically and verbally, Mr. Ali Burrows, is here too as everyone knew he would be, adding his touches to the field which very soon will be transformed by the arrival of its many visitors. Perhaps the most welcoming sight should it decide to rain on the day is the refreshment marquee, where the lady volunteers have the greatest say, laying out their tempting wares on the tables and preparing so many gallons of boiling water, in readiness for the hundreds of teacups that will soon be filled, emptied, and then washed ready to be used again.
And it was a big event, the treat, and we used to collect a ticket at school the week before treat day, and the ticket entitled you to a bag of buns, and I can never remember if we got a cup of tea or orange juice, I really can't. But on treat day we would assemble outside the school in Erston Village, a local band of some description would arrive, and at a given moment we marched, and we marched down the road from Erston to the treat field, which is not where the treat is held now, which is the Shiremoor Centre. It is where Backworth Station used to stand, which is now Northumberland Park Station, and it was the field on the left-hand side facing towards Hurleystone, and the treat was held there every year. It had been since 1907, actually.
Entrance to the field is free for the children, and so too is a traditional box of cakes, which for some will provide enough sustenance to last them the rest of the day. But for others, it's just the start of a gourmet-style afternoon's outing that will eventually reveal ice cream, candy floss, sweets, and an endless supply of their favourite pop.
You will find there were some naughty children, I wasn't one of them, some naughty children used to stand beside the railway line and pelt their buns at the passing electric trains, because the electric trains were running along what is now the metro line, and quite a lot of buns finished off on the railway line, unfortunately, but I personally ate all mine. Now, some of the bands who used to actually lead the children to the treat field were the marching jazz bands, they were called. They're not actually jazz bands insofar as they play things like trumpets and trombones and saxophones. They play kazoos and they beat drums and so forth. But they were quite a thing in the local area at the time. And on treat day, they marched in competition. And they would have their medals and they got little cups. Now, they wanted somebody to present the cups. From the committee. I wasn't on the committee, but I was the only one wearing a suit. Everybody else was wearing jeans. And so John Page, who was the guy who was actually the secretary at the time, said, "You go and hand these things out." And I said, "Am I going to do that?" He said, "You're the only one wearing a suit," he said.
The Leamington Cossacks Junior Jazz Band arrived first, one of the many others who come here every year in competition, the winners adding to their collection of medals that will be gained after a judging session in their own fenced-off arena.
Was a wonderful occasion. I remember it being gloriously sunny days. It couldn't have always been gloriously sunny days, but in my memory, it's gloriously sunny days. After all of these things happened, we had a few shillings in our pockets, shillings, old English money, and we were going to the amusements, and we were going to the dodgems and the waltzer, and we would throw darts at boards, and we would fire air rifles. These are things you don't get on these shows now because of health and safety regulations. Air rifles would not be allowed now.
We try to keep the traditional things that you would see at a fair, such as Punch and Judy, and maybe acrobatics, and those that may do acts in the circus, you know.
Not all police work involves traffic control and chasing lawbreakers. Sometimes they're able to relax through PT displays, etc. And visiting us today are two teams from Durham County Police Cadets, being put through their paces by Sergeant Nixon, illustrating how fitness is achieved through recreational exercises. Even among all the noise, it's still possible to get back to nature. The pony rides as ever, being a firm favourite of the children.
One idea of ours was to get the kids at school to make what they called the big heads, and they would put them over the head. But unfortunately, the kids didn't like them, they were frightened of them, you know. So we thought we'd better ditch that idea, because they were really, really frightened, you know. One year we had Bobby Thompson to open it, and he was a well-known comedian in Whitley Bay in Newcastle. And so it was so popular, I've got a picture of him with my niece and a friend in the little car he had a ride in.
Always colourful, amusing and pleasing to the crowds is a children's fancy dress parade. And after their saunter around the field, are presented by yet another well-known personality, Mr. Eddie Mill, one-time MP for Blythe.
The under 5 age group, Mark Johnson took the first prize as King Richard. Anna Marie as the fortune teller came second, and third place went to Helen Turnbull as the bride.
As the day wore on, we would always look forward to going to the rides and the amusements, which were just down the bottom, Murphy's Amusements, I think they were. But we'd have the finals of the football, the school football tournament, and the girls' netball tournament had been held. It was a knockout competition held through the school year, and the finalists played the game off at the treat field, and it was a big event. If you won the football or the netball, you got a little cup, and you thought you'd win the FA Cup.
Good afternoon and welcome to Shiremoor Park, where in the yellow strips, Shiremoor are at home to Holystone in the under 9 football competition. And as you can see, a record crowd has turned out to see this elimination match.
The presentation of the trophies to the netball teams was made by a man very familiar to netting the ball, Mr. Rob Hindmarsh, captain of Sunderland AFC.
Every year since a child, I've really enjoyed it, you know, the rides, the candy floss, the toffee apples. It's just something to look forward to every summertime. Hopefully the rain stays off or the welly boots come out, because you never miss it.
It brings the community closer together, I think. You see people that you haven't seen for a long time, you know, you get bring back relationships with people, I suppose, as well. And it's nice to see the kids enjoying themselves and getting excited for something as well. And it's nice that it's like your area that it's happening in.
The Shiremoor Treat brings together the communities. You know, you get to interact with and see people who you wouldn't normally see on a day-to-day. It's just a great event and it's valued deeply.
It's just part of Shiremoor, it's always been there. It's what somebody who lives in Shiremoor can always relate to.
It's a really good time for the family, it's really fun. And Shiremoor Back Wharf have loads of sports games like football, netball's going on, dance is going on, rugby's going on too. So yeah, it's a really good time for the family.
Because it's like once a year, like in the summer, where like we can go down just like somewhere local and go like on the fair instead of go down to their Newcastle to the town where. If like you're just wandering for a day out and then like you just see like the treat and then you just go and then like it's really fun. Like I go with my friends all the time, so yeah, I like it a lot.
Basically the treat is just it's not just a fair and it's not just a let's go and have a good time. It's basically it shows you what the community is about. And it shows you the involvements about what people can put into it. Like over the years people put that much into it, like it's gotten better. And it's not just for kids to enjoy, it's for the adults as well.
The success of the day depends largely on the support of the public. So why not come along yourselves next year? Perhaps a picnic in the sun, enjoy the sports, or just a quiet snooze. You may not be lucky enough to win one of the larger prizes, but one thing you can be sure of is that any offers of help with the washing up will be greatly appreciated. Whatever your choice, your support will make it another successful day for the children, which after all is what the treat is all about.
I would say it's just more people become involved and make sure the local community actually realises this is on and comes along and supports it. That's the main item. It'd be nice to get somebody to come along and sponsor the event in some way so we could put something special on some year. That would be even better. I mean, because in a region of £10,000 to £12,000 a year to put this event on, that's how much money we've got to raise every year just to keep going. So it's an awful lot of money that we've got to find. I mean, a lot of money's got to be found every year.
And so regrettably, the 1974 Shiremoor and District Children's Annual Gala draws to a close, as one by one the various groups, bodies, competitors and individuals leave for home. But perhaps you too will stop to think a while of the many unpaid helpers who have made this event the success it undoubtedly is. And if you have either cash or courage, perhaps you too next year might help these overworked people in their worthy task, even if it is only to help pick up the litter. But whatever help you can offer, it will only be rewarded by joy in the hearts of the children who will probably remember this day forever.
If you've never had the pleasure of being here before, here is your chance, it's an ever open door. So come and have a look around. Come on along to the Shiremoor Children's Treat. Come on along, many old friends you will meet. So if you wanna see this event keep going and keep the kids happy, come on along to the Shiremoor Children's Treat.